gas cap.
Yeah. What's in the bag? I want to show you guys something. I just found this at the dollar store. You know those things that pop up on every corner? So, Pink Floaty Nation is starting. Look at that. I have feather and glitter horse armband. And look at this guy. This guy is fucking gangster, dude. He's got his chain on, his thumbs up, got his hat all sideways. Come on. You knew it was coming. That guy is so fucking gangster. Excuse my language. Alright, what's going on, YouTube world? Welcome back. It's midnight. You guys wanted it, you guys got it. The midnight shot camera angle. Get on the Constantine baby girl. Hey, your alarm's going off. Maybe I need to go see if they need some help. I don't think they do. It looks like she's got it. Yep, she has got into her vehicle after not turning the alarm off. I think we're gonna be good right here. I think maybe right there. Okay, so I ordered a new mic, so you guys just have to deal with this crap. Until then. So what's going on, YouTube world? Deuces. What's up? It's a nice day. Let's get things started off right. Let's do this. Oh, that's perfect. Love it. I love old school music. Let's get it on tonight. Race mode. I need to turn that crap down. Got a joke for everyone today. What do potato chip bags and push-up bras have in common? And ladies, don't start getting mad. You did this to yourselves. When you open them up, they're both half full. Oh, that was pretty funny. So, I hope everyone's enjoying the weekend, whatever it is you see this video. Hope everyone's doing good. Time out. Make sure everything's zipped. We're zipped. We're zipped there. Cell phone's good. Alright. I got $1,100 in my pocket. I'm not gonna lose the shit. Hey, you should stop creeping forward there, creeper. Light's not gonna turn for you. There we go. We're good. So today's topic, you guys wanted it. You got the midnight shot camera angle going on. Hope you guys enjoy it. I think I'm gonna leave all the things here. My mic will be in this weekend. Ouch. Sometime, hopefully. I gotta go pick it up. And hopefully the audio quality will be a little bit better. I think this mic is probably gonna be popping right now. Every time I probably speak a little loud. Maybe I should soften up. So I wanted to talk to you guys today about people, those around you. Pay attention. Come on, focus here. Focus, midnight. You ruined a good car, piece of junk. I know, I'm not focusing very well. I'm probably random as shit right now. So, today's topic is about living. You know, oh, is this guy gonna hit me? Because if he does, I'm not gonna live very long. What's that, homie? You know, there comes a time in your life, I guess, when you get to a certain point, you start seeing those around you and start seeing that, you know, what's good for you and what's not. You know, some people are toxic. If you're in a toxic relationship, you gotta get out. It's no way to live. I think this guy to my left is stalking me. A Do I need to turn around and go get some? I will wear it so it's plumb out. What's up, crystals? So, you know, toxic people make a huge change in your life. They cause you a lot of grief, a lot of stress, a lot of problems. As that text I sent my friends one night when I was too trashed to drive home, no problematic. Yeah, there's a lot of problems. You know, and getting out of a relationship like that, even whether it's just being a friend, is, you know, kind of tricky. Because then drama starts, and then they start yelling and screaming, and now they're texting your Facebook friends, hey, you know what so-and-so said? It's not even true. Oh, hand wash car bikes. Ooh, what's up? I wonder if they wash my bike. What the hell was that? So, you know, these toxic people, the only thing they get out of the deal is just being in drama. And there's a lot of people like that out there in the world. I know, there's tons. The only thing they want is just to ruin somebody's day. What's up, dude? Everybody is so friendly today. I feel so good. You scare me. Really? They're trying to delay my music. They're trying to... I don't want to listen to your stuff. I want to listen to mine. And these toxic people can wreak havoc on your personal health. Well, a lot of things. They can cause you so much stress. They can ruin your relationship with others. You know, people you've been friends with for a long time. Why? Why must you people be toxic? My music's louder. You know, and trying to get away from these people again is really hard. It's tricky because they're going to start shit. They're going to, you know, don't even care. Because if your true friends believe them over you, knowing how they are, it's not worth it. You know, those are the people you need to stay away from, you know. And it's hard not to snap on people like that for me. You know, those people that are like, oh, well, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. If you don't talk to me, or you don't help me, or you don't, no. I'm not worried about that. Hey, you should probably go. You know, and those people, I think this car wants something. Having a close relationship, you have to be careful and not give too much information to them, because they could then take that information and hurt you. They can ruin your life. Come get some. With your air diffusers on your roof, on your car, that maybe does 30. So when dealing with toxic people, you do have to be very careful about what information it is you give them. Because if you put so much trust in them, they can and will hurt you quick. I'm going. So you have to pick and choose what you say to them. I understand being a decent person, it's hard. It's not easy to be that way. Because you wanna be nice. Oh, a camo. Mazda 6, really? A camo? Camel. Camo or camel? Camel tone. You know, and these toxic people are going to take any little bit of information, whether it's, oh, well, I went to bed last night, or, hey, I wear Scooby-Doo underwear. They're going to take that information and just blast it everywhere. And, you know, you see the Facebook post, you see the Instagram post about, nobody wants me, I'm this, I'm that. Oh, I'm so overwhelmed, I've got a bill to pay. And I just, you know, and my ex-boyfriend that left me 19 years ago was so violent to me, and it's just so toxic. What's up? You wanna go? Hey, you know, you can turn right. If you don't, I will. I will hit the gas pedal for you. Oh, I love 300Cs. Chrysler, thank you. You know, the best bet, when you see stuff like that, just get away. You don't really need to block them on Facebook. Just hide their posts. I mean, come on, people. Are we so dramatic? It's 2020. Are we that damn dramatic that we have to let the entire world know our business about why we are so alone? But you know what? You're so freaking alone in the world because you can't seem to get it. You're too ignorant to see that if you would just shut your mouth and stop blasting all your junk all over Facebook, somebody might actually pay attention to you. Nobody wants to be around that crap. I don't. Do you? Raise your hand if you want to be around me. You know, and you people need to see that that's not a good way to live. That's not a nice way to make friends. That's not a way to keep friends. It's not a way to keep really good people in your life. Because if you're anything like me, which I know a lot of my subscribers, you guys have a good heart. And I know personally some of you I've spoke with either A, over the phone or through messaging back and forth, DMs, whatever. And what the hell is a DM? DM. I don't get what a DM is anymore. It's a PM. It's a private message, right? Well, anyways. And a lot of you guys and girls, haven't forgot the ladies, you know, you're like me. You guys got a big heart. You care about people. You don't want to see people go through hard times. You don't want to see people struggle. You don't want people feeling like they're lonely. Oh, I love it. Top is down on a Miata. Oh, I love it. Thank you. Sorry, I'm an NB2 owner and I'm a Miata fan. Hey, what's up, girl? Oh, you're a dude. I got scared. Damn dude in the road trying to hang a kern. I think he had his knee out the door. You know, a lot of people are there for people when they need them. But continually blasting your garbage over Facebook about how lonely you are for the 938th day. Come on, that's not gonna get you nowhere. I know it's hard. I know it's really bad. Oh, it's a squid rocket. Jixer. But come on, guys. If you see someone like that, just, you know, there's really no polite way to tell them, you know, hey, look, we don't care about your crap. Because all you're doing is turning my news feed or my inbox or my time to myself to smile and laugh. Now I gotta look at your shit. Why? You know, I saw you post so-and-so the other day and now you're still posting about it. Jesus Christ, that was 15 years ago. Get over it. Mustang's trying to go somewhere. I hope it's got crowd control on. Sorry, Mustang owners. That was a quick jab. So be polite, guys. Come on. Nobody wants to hear your drama, but there are some people out there in the world like myself who, you know, we try to be there for others. And again, I'm not perfect. I haven't been there for others when they needed me, but yet that person was there for me when I needed them. It's humility. It's, you know, being humble. And that's something a lot of people need back in this world, because, you know, I'm yes ma'am, no ma'am, yes sir, no sir. I don't care how old you are, I'm gonna call you ma'am. I'm gonna give you that respect. But don't take what I tell you and then turn around and trash it. Not good. So here's the moment you guys waited for. Midnight camera angles back. Mike will be in, so this little dangly thing will be gone here hopefully by the weekend. So until next time, guys, you guys got it. Stay safe out there. Keep the rubber side up in the air. Make it do a flip and baby squirrel. Until next time, guys, I'm Midnight. See ya.